The elementary trigonometry. So far, we have come up to height and distance. Now, I think we have already covered the portions which are now prescribed for 10th standard. Now, what I am going to do now is trigonometric ratios of allied angles. Trigonometric ratios of allied angles. This I am going to start today. Now, this I think will be in 11th standard. In school, it will be in 11th standard. Now, for those of you who are in first sem diploma in the 9 scheme, that is 9SC01M, what we did already, that is also there, and this what we are doing now, this will also be there. Now, for those who have joined during 15, 16 or later than that, it will start from here. Now, this is a chapter called Trigonometric Ratios of Allied Angles. Now, this will get you around 15 marks. Around 15 marks you will get in this chapter. Okay, we will see that later. First, let us see what is this trigonometric ratios of allied angles. Now, so far we have studied how to find the trigonometric ratios of angles which are less than 90 degrees. Which are less than 90 degrees. That is, they are also called as acute angles. 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, etc. They are all less than 90 degrees and they are called acute angles. Now, if the angle is greater than 90 degree. Now, for example, if I have to find out what is the sine of 150 degree, for example, sine of 150 degree or cos of 150 degree, then how to do it? Now, this comes in allied angles. This we call as an allied angle because the angle is greater than 90 degree. Now, to do this, what we have to do is, we have to take reference as, see, this angle we have two axes, the x-axis and the y-axis. Now, this is our zero, this is the starting point always, that is the zero. Now, 150 means it is coming from somewhere here. This is 150 degree. This angle is 150 degree. It is greater than 90 degrees. Now, this can be taken as, this will be taken as either sine of 90 plus 60, 90 plus 60 degrees, or it can be taken as sine of 180 minus 30 degrees. That is, this will be taken as a reference line. This line or this line will be taken as a reference line. You know, this is 90. So, 150 degree will be 90 plus 60, or it can be 180 minus 30 degree. This angle will be 30 degree. Similarly, if you get the angle somewhere here, this is called first quadrant. We call this as first quadrant. This is called as the second quadrant. This is called as the third quadrant and this is called as the fourth quadrant. So, there, if it comes here, it can be taken as 180 plus something or 270 degree minus something. If it comes here, 270 plus or 360 minus, we can take like that. So, we will take this as reference line. Now, whether we take this line as a reference line or this line, whatever it is, this is not going to come in the final this thing. This will be equal to cos 60 degree and this will be equal to sine 30 degree. What is going to come is this angle only, this or this angle only. This is not going to come, whether it is 90, 180, 270, 360, whatever it is. This angle is not going to come in the final answer. What is going to come is this only. you remember this. This 90, 180, we'll take that only for reference. We'll take it for reference and it won't be coming here. See, when an angle is in first quadrant, see, our triangle is like this. This was our triangle we started. This is theta. Here, this is the opposite side. This is positive. This is adjacent side. This is also positive. This is hypotenuse. That is also positive. Now, hence, all ratios here will be positive. All. That is, there are six ratios. That is sine, cos, tan, cosecant, secant and cot. All the ratios, because it will be plus by divided by plus, sine will be this divided by this, plus divided by plus, cos will be this by this, plus divided plus, tan will be this divided by this. So everything will be positive. All the ratios, all the six ratios will be positive. If the angle is here, what happens is this adjacent side is negative. This is negative. This is positive. This is positive. Now, in whichever ratio you get adjacent side, that ratios, those ratios will be negative. Only the ratios in which this and this side are there, that is opposite and hypotenuse are there, only these ratios will be positive. The other ratios, trigonometric ratios, will be negative because this is negative. So here, only here all will be positive. Here only sine is, you know, opposite by hypotenuse. So sine will be positive. Its reciprocal, that is cosecant, will be positive. Other four ratios will be negative in the second quadrant. In the third quadrant, what happens is, if the angle is here, the triangle will come here. Now this is negative. This is also negative. This is positive. Now, only that ratio in which opposite and adjacent side are there, that is tan and cot, it's reciprocal. The reciprocal of tan is cot. So, those two ratios will be positive and the other ratios will be negative. When the angle is in fourth quadrant, this is positive. This is always positive. Hypotenuse is always positive. Adjacent is positive, opposite is negative. Now only that, those ratios which are having adjacent and hypotenuse, they will be positive. That is cos and secant. Cos, the reciprocal of cos is secant. Those two will be positive. Other four ratios will be negative. Now to remember it easily, what we do is, we give it like this. In first quadrant, all are positive. So we write A is positive. A means all are positive. Here, sine and its reciprocal, that is sine and cosecant, are positive. So it is represented by S. Here, tan and its reciprocal, that is cot, they are positive. Others are negative. So it will be T. And here, cos and secant will be positive. That is C. So we write like this, A, S, T, C. We write like this, A, you can note it in one corner, you can note, A, S, T, C. Even in exam, you can have this as a reference, this thing, you can have it. In the examination, in your answer book, you can write like this, A, S, T, C. A is all, S is sine, T is tan, C is cos. If sine is positive, then its reciprocal, that is cosecant, will be positive. If tan is positive, its reciprocal, that is cot, will be positive. If cos is positive, then its reciprocal secant will be positive. Others will be negative. Now, to remember this, what we do is, we can remember it like this. All students take coffee. All students take coffee. A stands for all, S for students, T for take, C for coffee. All students take coffee. You can remember like this. It is written like this, A, S, T, C. Now, we are going to write the relationships for various allied angles. First, functions of 90 minus theta. First, we will take up 90 minus theta. That is, see, in this triangle, if this is theta, then this angle becomes 90 minus theta. This becomes 90 minus theta. So you can make a triangle like this. This is the adjacent side. This is the opposite side. It will be like that. Now, this 90 minus theta means it will be here. This is 90 minus theta. So we should, the angle comes in first quadrant. So what is sine of 90 minus theta? 90 minus theta cos 90 minus theta tan 90 minus theta cosecant 90 minus theta secant 90 minus theta and cot 90 minus theta. See here, there is one rule. You remember this rule, that whenever we get 90 or 270, that is this line. This line is, one end is 90 degree, the other end is 270. If you get 90 or 270 here, sine changes to cos. Cos changes to sine. Tan changes to cot. Cosecant changes to secant. Secant changes to cosecant. And cot changes to tan. When we are having 90 plus or 90 minus or 270 plus 270 minus, when we have 90 or 270, this will be happening. When you have 180 and 360, 180 or 360 is there, then sine will be sine only, cos will be cos only, tan will be tan only. Similarly, cosecant will be cosecant, secant will be secant, and cot will be cot. You remember this. This depends upon this value that you get here. Now, this angle, any angle which is 90 minus theta is in first quadrant. So, all are positive. All the six are positive here. In the first quadrant, you know, we know all will be positive. So, this will be cos theta. Because this is 90, cos theta. This will be sin theta. This will be tan cot theta. This will be secant theta. This will be cosecant theta. And this will be tan theta. So these are the functions. You have to remember this. Next, if it is 90 plus theta, 90 plus theta, what happens? If it is 90 plus theta, second one, this is now in second quadrant. The angle will be in second quadrant. That is, it will be more than 90 degree, but less than 180 degree. It is in second quadrant. Now, what will be sine 90 plus theta? 90 plus theta, cos 90 plus theta, tan 90 plus theta, cosecant 90 plus theta, secant 90 plus theta, and cot 90 plus theta. Now the angle will be in second quadrant. So in second quadrant, sine will be positive. Its reciprocal, that is cos, will be positive. The other four ratios will be negative. The other four ratios will be negative. Again, because I am getting 90, 90, 90 here, sine will become cos theta. This 90 will go, it will become cos theta. Cos will become sine theta. Tan will become cot theta. Cosecant will become secant theta. Secant will become cosecant theta. And cot will become tan theta. So these are the six ratios of 90 plus theta. Next, third one, 180 minus theta, trigonometric functions of 180 minus theta. Now, this is also 180 minus theta means it is in second quadrant only. So, this is second quadrant only. Again, what is sine 180 minus theta? Cos 180 minus theta. Tan 180 minus theta. Cosecant 180 minus theta. Secant 180 minus theta. And cot 180 minus theta. Now these will be, sine is positive, the angle is in second quadrant, it is less than 180 degree, so it is in second quadrant. Sine will be positive, cosecant will be positive, the other four will be negative. So the sine depends upon where the location of the angle in which quadrant it is. So these are the signs. Here now we are getting 180. So this sine will be sine only, sine of theta. Sine 180 minus theta will be same as sine theta. Cos 180 minus theta will be cos theta only. Tan 180 minus theta will be tan theta. Cosecant will be cosecant theta. Secant will be secant theta. And cot theta will be cot theta only. No change will take place. If it is 180 or 360, they will all remain the same. So, these are the functions, six trigonometric functions of 180 minus theta. Next, we go to fourth one, that is 180 plus theta. 180 plus theta. This is fourth one. 180 plus theta. Now it comes to third quadrant. 180, it is more than 180 but less than 270. It will be in third quadrant. So what are the functions, trigonometric functions of 180 plus theta? 180 plus theta, cos 180 plus theta, tan 180 plus theta, cosecant 180 plus theta, secant 180 plus theta, cot 180 plus theta. Now the angle is in third quadrant. In third quadrant, tan and its reciprocal are positive, that is tan and cot are positive. The remaining four are negative. This is negative, this is negative, this is negative, this is negative. Because this is 180, the reference is to the horizontal axis, 180 degree. So sine will be sine only, sine theta. Cos will be cos only, that is cos theta. Tan theta. Cosecant theta. Secant theta. And cot theta. Cot theta. These are the trigonometric ratios of 180 plus theta. Six trigonometric ratios of 180 plus theta. Next, fifth one is, in third quadrant, it can be written as either 180 plus theta or it can be written as 270 minus theta. 270 minus theta. This is also in third quadrant. So, what is sine of 270 minus theta cos of 270 minus theta tan of 270 minus theta cosecant 270 minus theta secant 270 minus theta cot 270 minus theta. Again tan and cot are positive, tan is positive, cot is positive, the remaining are negative, right? Sine is like that. Now this is 270 here, so because it is 270, sine becomes cos theta, cos becomes sin theta, tan becomes cot theta, cosecant becomes secant theta, secant becomes cosec theta, and cot will be tan theta. Right? So this is third quadrant, 270 minus theta. Now, sixth one will be 270 plus theta. 270 plus theta. Now it is in fourth quadrant. Now sine 270 plus theta sine 270 plus theta cos 270 plus theta tan 270 plus theta cosecant 270 plus theta secant 270 plus theta and cot 270 plus theta. Now the angle is in the fourth quadrant, that is it is greater than 270, less than 360, so it is in fourth quadrant. In fourth quadrant cos is positive and its reciprocal, that is secant, will be positive. The remaining four ratios will be negative. Sine, tan, cosecant and cot will be negative. Now again this is 270, so this will be cos theta, this will be sin theta, this will be cot theta, this will be secant theta, this will be cosecant theta and this will be tan theta. So these are the ratios, trigonometric ratios of angle which falls in the fourth quadrant, that is it is greater than 270 but less than 360. Next, this 270 plus theta can also be written as seventh, I think, 360 minus theta. 360 minus theta. That way also it can be written. So sine of, this is also in fourth quadrant, sine of 360 minus theta cos 360 minus theta tan 360 minus theta cosecant 360 minus theta secant 360 minus theta cot 360 minus theta. Again it is less than 360, that means the angle is between 270 and 360, so cos will be positive and its reciprocal secant will be positive. The remaining four will be negative. These four will be negative. Now because this is 360, you are taking the reference with this axis, horizontal axis. Sine will be sine only, so it will be sine theta, this will be cos theta, this will be tan theta, this will be cosec theta and this will be secant theta and this is cot theta only. So this is the trigonometric ratios of 360 minus theta. Next, the trigonometric ratios of 360 plus theta. That is, the angle is greater than, eighth one, angle is greater than 360, means it again comes to the first quadrant. It comes back to first quadrant. It is more than 360, but it is between 0 and it will come to first quadrant. It comes to first quadrant, 360 plus theta. So sine of 360 plus theta, cos of 360 plus theta, tan of 360 plus theta, cosecant 360 plus theta, secant 360 plus theta, and cot 360 plus theta. Now these angles fall in first quadrant, so all will be positive, all ratios will be positive first quadrant. Sine is sine only because we have taken this as the reference 360, so cos will be cos only, tan will be tan only, cosecant is cosecant only, secant is secant only, and cot is cot. So these are the trigonometric ratios. We have covered one round. We know the first one, this thing, 90 minus theta, 90 plus theta, 180 minus theta, 180 plus theta, 270 minus theta, 270 plus theta, 360 minus theta, 360 plus theta. So we have come one round, and these formulae are the formulae which are known as the trigonometric ratios of allied angles. You may be thinking that it is very difficult, so many formulae are there. If you use these formulae again and again in various problems, when you are doing problems, if you use them again and again and again, if you are using them, it becomes simple, very simple, it becomes normal. Now, there was a time in our school when all of us were struggling to remember a plus b the whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Today it looks very silly that a plus b the whole square is a square plus 2ab. If somebody is mugging in our home, some youngster is mugging, then we feel that, oh, what this fellow is doing. But we also passed through that same thing. Now it has become very easy for us because we have been using it over and over again and again. So it becomes easy. Similarly, all formulae become easy once you start using them. Now we have to apply these formulae in problems which we are going to get in our examinations. We are going to get these problems. We have to solve them. We have to solve them. When we solve these problems, we will be using them, using these formulae, and as we use them, we become used to it, we become accustomed to it. Now we will solve some problems here. I'll take up these problems. Now I have selected some problems from your question papers 9SC01M. This is the first semester question paper of students who have joined first semester diploma before 2015, that is 9 to 15, those of you who have joined. I have taken the question paper problem of April, May 2018, first, that is the latest examination. In this paper, there are four questions which are covered in this particular chapter. Three questions carrying 5 marks and one carrying 2 marks. So totally there are 4 questions. From these 4 questions, you will get 17 marks. Now, he says like this, first problem from section A. This is from section A, problem number 8. The problem is like this. If sine theta is equal to 4 by 5, find tan theta. Find tan theta. Now, what he has done here is, he has given one the value of one trigonometric ratio of theta, and he is asking us to find out another trigonometric ratio of the same angle theta. Now, this is not exactly allied angle, but this question can be asked in allied angle also. Now, this is, he hasn't said where is theta. Where is theta, he hasn't said. If he hasn't given anything about that, then we have to assume that theta is acute. That is, it is less than 90 degree. Acute means it is less than 90 degree. So, it is in first quadrant. It is in first quadrant. Now, what we do, we will draw a rough figure. Let us say this is theta. We draw a rough figure. It is in first quadrant. The angle is in first quadrant. He has given sine. If you know sine, you know sine by definition. Sine theta is opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposites. You have to use, keep using these relationships so that it becomes by heart. Automatically it becomes by heart. Now if I give some names, O, A, B. Now, AB is opposite side and OA is hypotenuse. OA by AB. Now, this value of sine theta is given as 4 by 5. So, AB is 4 and OA is 5 and we don't know OB. We know two sides. If they have given one trigonometric ratio of an angle, we know two sides of that triangle. Two sides of the triangle. Because sine is given here, we know the opposite side and we know the value of sine theta is given. So, we know the opposite side and we know the hypotenuse. Now, we have to get the adjacent side. We have to get OB. Now, what we can do is, we can apply Pythagoras theorem. You know, OB square will be equal to OA square minus AB square. Because this is hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is square is equal to sum of the squares on the other two sides. OA square will be equal to OB square plus AB square. If this plus AB square goes that side, it becomes minus. So, OB square will be equal to 5 square minus 4 square. That is 25 minus 16. It becomes 9. OB square is equal to